Welcome back to TV5 News at 9. Today we are talking about proton therapy with medical director Dr. Hashom Gayar. Thank you so much for being here. We appreciate you joining in.
My pleasure. I'm glad to be with you.
Great. Okay, listen to this. First, we're going to talk about proton therapy and how it's different from just regular radiation, doctor.
Proton therapy is a form of a particle therapy. While regular conventional radiation goes through the body and everything in the way gets the beam of radiation, proton therapy is a subatomic particle, too small to be seen even with electronic microscope. And it is delivered via a high energy machine that can go as a very, very tiny rocket that goes through tissue, giving minimal radiation damage in the way. But when it reaches to the target, it deploys and diffuses the energy, treating 3 to 7 millimeter spots. Wow. And we can manage those spots to be precisely present at the target, avoiding unnecessary radiation to normal tissue, and there is no exit. So the ability to treat the cancer only or the target only and avoid treating surrounding normal tissue is the advantage of proton therapy over conventional radiation, which treats everything through the way as it goes. So it is a superior method of radiation treatment, and it's indicated when radiation is indicated, but the ability to spare normal tissue allows us to deliver higher doses right where they belong at the cancer, in small spots that can three-dimensionally precisely positioned. In the meantime, we spare normal tissue, and that reduces the side effects and improves quality of life.
Wow, that is amazing. Today, let's talk about head and neck cancers, doctor. Now, is proton therapy beneficial for those cancers?
Head and neck cancer and brain, I might as well include the brain and the basal skull, is a critical part of the body that includes many sensitive organs. And the more critical organs you have, we're talking here the eyes, the brain, the salivary glands, part of the sensors in the body, mastication, swallowing, breathing. It's many critical organs, the voice box, and so on. So when you are able to spare normal tissue and still treat the target with radiation that goes only where it belongs, you have superior outcome. You have ability to cure more because you can go to safely higher doses. You have ability to spare normal tissue, hence reduce side effects, and being able to cure the cancer better. And the patients doesn't need to be hospitalized. Even when chemotherapy is given together with radiation, the side effects are much less because the exit dose, when you treat head and neck cancer, for example, throat cancer, tonsil, base of tongue, floor of mouth, and so on, those areas are critical organs are very close by. And if you spare the salivary glands, you don't have the dryness, you don't have the soreness in the mouth and the throat. We don't have patients who need a bag or an access to the stomach for feeding. So significant improvement when you treat any head and neck cancer with proton superior to conventional radiation because of sparing the side effects, better quality of life, ability to give other treatments safely. When you come to the brain, even small doses of radiation to the brain can save and spare eloquent centers. And now we're learning that even tiny doses of radiation to sensitive parts like the speech, the vision center in the brain, the areas that control the balance, the ability to talk, the motor and the sensory centers in the brain, even reduces minimal radiation is of value. So any brain tumor, any meningioma or benign tumors of the coverings of the brain, and the longer the patient is expected to live, the more important the savings and sparing side effects. We're talking about treating children that will live for the rest of their life, suffering from consequences of treatment, or young people, or adults that have years to live. Why suffer and have diminished ability of parts of the brain or parts of the head and neck areas or the eyes or damage to optic nerve or the nerves that supply the sensory, the smell, the ability to talk, and so on. So many critical organs in the head and neck that can be spared. Hence, the quality of life is better and the treatment outcomes are better. The patient tolerates the treatment as an outpatient and go to work afterwards. Wow. You don't need to be hospitalized. You don't need to have the side effects we all see sometimes from conventional treatment.
Well, it sounds like a win-win therapy. I love it. Now, how can people find out, doctor, if proton therapy is right for them?
If you have diagnosis of cancer, or if radiation is one of the options that could be used for your cancer, explore. And the best way is to just call us with your information. We will be glad to listen to what you have, go over the facts, and see if it's worth it for you, if you could benefit. Then we can evaluate your case in particular, give you an answer, and we have people that are specialized to receive the information, coordinate the facts. And if it's worth it, a visit to the center will go over the diagnosis and the treatment, especially for your case. And we treat, it's patient issue. It's not, we're not treating the cancer. We're treating the individual that has the cancer. Everyone has their own personal needs, and it's personalized treatment. And the targeted therapy is so meticulous that can spare organs, and it is not a common stamp for everyone. Every individual case has particular planning and design that goes with the diagnosis and the treatment effect. Call us. Call the Cancer Center, or call 855-MY-PROTON or 855-697-7686. Or email us, and we'll exchange information, and if you're the right candidate, we'll take care of you. Sometimes, like left-sided breast cancer, the heart is close by, and to spare the heart is a big deal. Later on in life, radiation can cause damage to the heart. Ischemic heart disease can occur. Heart attacks and things like that are reduced when we use proton for left-sided breast cancer. Lung cancer, esophagus cancer, pancreas, prostate cancer. We can spare the rectum and avoid rectal bleeding. There are many indications, not only in the head and neck and the brain, but the head and neck and the brain is a primary area with many critical organs that would benefit the most from this treatment.
So get the first step, get in touch with Dr. Gayar. Thank you so much, doctor, for joining us today with this valuable information. We appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
You are welcome. And for more information, just visit the hotlink section that's at WNEM.com.